Okay guys, so I'm going to give you a quick little tour of the inside of the locker here. Yeah, this is the last, you see the little platform I made? It's got four wheels on the bottom of it, and it's 2 feet by 4 feet. And it's so that I can just take this whole thing and move it out so I can get at whatever's behind this. Okay, I have quite a bit of some parts cabinets there, but just stuff that I normally get at all the time. There's two wooden shelves there that have most of the stuff on them. This is all my camping stuff. It's all in on a rolly thing that I can wheel out if I need to. And then there's a little extra room on the top for storage. Over here I've got the solar system. The panels are behind it, and then I've got the solar. This has been here for almost a year and a half now, and I've still got juice. I can just power this up and get, you know, my lights to come on and stuff like that in here. Or I can charge my cell phone through this. This is directly connected to the battery, and then I've got a little USB thingy there. USB to micro USB. My little drill press there. I got my table saw over here. My tools are in that box. Like if I got to go and do some work on a whatever, like woodworking tools, they're in there. Levels, squares, all that stuff. I got my DeWalt, all my jigsaw, skill saw, torque, whatever. My Stanley cabinet with all the tools in it. And then I got like hammers and stuff in this. This is all boxes of stuff that I bought, like the internal boxes. That box is going back with this barbecue once COVID is over and done with, and I'm allowed to take it back to the Wally World. And my dresser underneath here for my bedroom set. And there's the other small barbecue that I just put together the other day. There's my 1,000-watt Sony 5.1 surround sound system that I'm probably going to end up selling. My old filing cabinet has got some stuff in it. Pretty well anything that I ever designed and made, it ended up, it's got its own little place in that filing cabinet. There's a Siemens sticker. Well, I'll get rid of that fucking thing. So going on a little further back. So this is my workbench here. This wooden part is still together, and basically this is the table, my workbench, and then this from here to the floor sits on top of the work table. What I should do is put it together, and then I have a workstation sitting here. But basically I've just got all my boxes of clothes. I've got so many extra clothes. I gotta go through these and get rid of some of them. So that's what's there. There's the old red recliner and my futon mattress, and the futon is stuffed in here. All the rails and stuff for the futon are all packed up into that section right there. Okay, going on to the next one here. This is where I have this table I don't really use, but underneath here are all the different computer boxes and stuff like that. That's my second CNC machine that I built, otherwise known as R2-D2. Can't really see it. I should turn on the light. There we go. So yeah, my second CNC machine that I built, all with my own controller board and stuff like that, it's sitting here. On top of it is my 3D printer and the rack that I made, or not the rack, but the cabinet I made to hold the spools of PDL or PLA or whatever it's called. Yeah, got more computer boxes up there. Brand new bike rack I've never used. Down here are a whole bunch of boxes that are all the same size, right behind these chairs. They're all the same size. Anyways, and they're all sorted. I put all, like, most of them are used things. Not all of them, but I think there's like 50 boxes there or something like that. So this piece here at the back is on wheels. As you can see down here, or right here, you can see one of the wheels. That has parts cabinets on both sides. I have 32 or 35 parts cabinets. And all the ones that I could fit are on that rack. So it's both sides. I can wheel that thing out, flip it around, turn it around, whatever I want to do. I keep this large piece of wood in front of the cabinets just so nothing falls and knocks the drawers out or anything like that. Here's where I got all my coats and stuff like that hanging on a... I forget what they called that thing, but it's on wheels too. I can take that out, wheel it down to the end if I want. So yeah, right here, all the way along here are 90 banana boxes, and they've all got stuff in them. Some of them I've got to go and, you know, get rid of or whatever. I don't need, I got to try and get rid of 30 of these. So I'm going to, take some wire and stuff like that and, to the recycling and get rid of this. I need to make room for 30 more that are at the house. So, because I need to get them back in here. I need to clean up my room and make some space and stuff. So, yeah. So these wheel out here. I'm going to set the camera down and show you. But like I said before, all the drones are behind here. So I'm just going to set the phone down here somewhere where it will keep recording me. Hopefully without falling on the floor. But basically, you just grab these like this and slide them across. Roll them out. Yeah. Without wrecking anything. That's a goofy light that I made. Pretty cool, but it's hard to show it to somebody to sell it online, because the only way it's any useful to show anybody is if it's actually got music going to it and you can see the lights going. But if anybody lives around here locally and thinks they might like that, I could sell it to you. Anyways, I'm gonna have to move the phone again. So just move it over here for now. So I'm gonna pull this section out. And behind here are my 47 drones. So I gotta find one in particular here to get out. But they're all on these racks here. There's a whole bunch of them. It starts back there. And then, you know, basically all my drones resting here, 47 of them. So what I'm looking for is the drones that look like a helicopter. There they are. There's mine. So I need to take that with me. But yeah, there's some other stuff packed in at the bottom there and stuff, but basically they're all stored on that set of racks. So like I said, if I need to get any, this is my Phantom 3 Pro, my what's it called, Zero Explorer's in that one, which is really not in that one. That's just the box for it. There's the Zero Explorer there. Yeah, so some of this other stuff, I, you know, it's for sale, like the eight camera what do you call it, surveillance system. These are some dishes that I bought from Amazon that are just way too fancy, and I don't want to use them anymore. So there's a sewing machine down there I got for sale, and the box. But anyways, all my albums and stuff are at the bottom there. But this is the rack that I keep all that stuff on. That's the one drone I just took out, the SEMA. Looks like a helicopter, like a real helicopter. So yeah, so that's how I get at the drones when I want to. I can just, move everything over. I just got to move this one last rack over here. This is the one that has all my camping gear in it. So I got these wheels off of Amazon and basically just bought a half inch, 3/4 inch plywood, 4x4 sheet and cut it in half. So that's how I ended up making these little dollies and stuff. It makes it really easy when you want to get in here and get at stuff. So this locker is about, I would say probably half full. If you really, really wanted to pack stuff in here, you could. This is where I got all my drone related stuff. This is my ground station and display tripod and stuff like that. The rest of them are all drone parts. My RC cars are up there. There's old tools and stuff in those boxes. But yeah, basically there's my green screen. Whatever you call that thing. Green screen for, I've never done it yet, but gotta do it sooner or later. Luggage I bought that I'm gonna never end up using, but yeah, so I'll just move this last one here. See if I can't put the camera down again. Don't fall over. So this one hasn't got much on it, it's just got this little barbecue and a few boxes, so I can just now take this and just wheel it down the end here. So it makes getting at stuff in the locker really, really easy. So this is what's in here, like a car stuff that you use for working on a car, windshield wiper fluid, nuts and bolts and stuff like that. Some kitchen things like my George Foreman grill and a mixer and another mixer and my toaster. What do you call it? Crock pot. These are the only two parts cabinets that would not fit on that big wheelie one at the back. Someday I may rearrange it just to see if I can get it on there and everything, but oh, and look at this. There's the Invisible Touch. I got an album here just in case I want to play it. That needs to go back in with my albums back here. Yeah, so yeah, that's how I keep everything all nice and organized. Some of these drones are not finished yet, but most of them are. Yeah, so this one I'm waiting on a camera cable, which I don't think I even ordered it. There's a whack of them in the back here. A bunch more in here. This is a fun one to fly, this ARF 210. Yeah, so there's one of the big ones there. My other big one's way up the top here. See, you'll see it at the top. They're too big to fit on the shelf. So that's the X4, and that is the ZD850 there, that one. The idea was to put, I got the X8 that I need to put up there. So I got to find a spot for it. I may end up putting the ZD850 down here. But, and that's the, what was it called? The FY680. I took that apart because I had a bad BEC, and I never put it back together again. So I gotta get that finished, put back together again. So yeah, so that's basically it. My life in a storage locker, thanks to Dick Dean. So, yep. The storage locker. Thanks for watching, guys. I hope you guys found this very interesting. If you have any questions, please don't hesitate to ask. I'll gladly answer any question you'd like. I'm an electronics guy. Oh, there's my 308, 3018 CNC up there, packed away. That's my small, I think that was my third CNC. Also, I have the laser engraver here, and I have the other one at the house. That one's just a little tiny one. But, yeah. What a pile of junk. Thanks for watching, guys.